Virgo, my loves, how are you guys doing? This is going to be your March 2022 reading. So, I have a friend, Jakey Poo, my god brother, who did a bone reading for me earlier this month. And he inspired me to pull my set out and, practice with it. And I was like, I need to because I bought this a couple of years ago and only played with it a few times. But I was like, let me get into this. So that is why we are here. This month we are doing bone readings. We're going to add a little bit of tarot at the end. Milo, don't you scratch me. So let's see what we got going on for Virgo. If you like this, let me know in the comments because I'm all about adding new content to my channel, trying new things out. And if this works, I would love to incorporate more of it in. Plus, it'll help me get stronger with the readings too, Virgo. So let's see. Virgo. Let me get my heart in here. All right, Virgo. What is going on for Virgo March 2022? Virgo March 2022 spirit. Let's see what we have. Oh, all right. So, first thing, if you've been having health issues, transformation definitely is coming in. Recovery is on top. Now, we definitely have the dead, which is spirit. And this could be them. If you are going to the doctor, they could be pinpointing certain things that are wrong with you. But I'm definitely getting that there's transformation. There is some type of recovery on top of sickness, which means if you've been dragging, your energy's been low, you've been having other medical problems, that some of you may actually start feeling a whole lot better. And I do see that because of this could be spirit, and it looks like that it's coming in pretty quick because we got an arrow pointing right at the head. For some of you, though, these could be migraines, these could be headaches, but there's some type of improvement that's going to be coming in. Now, on the car, on the vehicle, we have the catcher's mask met. What is it? Oh, Lord. I just had a brain fart, Virgo. Mitt. Like, what the hell am I trying to say? It is right on top of the car. So, if some of you have been looking for a vehicle, I feel like that there's going to be some good news about a vehicle coming in. I'm not getting any claws or anything that would cause a problem. So, I feel like some of you might be looking for a vehicle. This can also be, too, using your vehicle to transport a lot of things. So for some of you, there may be some type of move. Maybe you're looking at a larger vehicle because this was on the back in the trunk. And it could be because maybe you have some business or something that is increasing and you need to go ahead and get it. Some of you might even be getting some type of RV or bigger truck or something so that you can transport things in. But I'm definitely feeling that there may be looking into other vehicles are modifying your vehicle, Virgo. Let's see. If this is not your vehicle, some of you may even be dealing with another person with a car problem or something that needs to be taken care of. And I feel like that you're going to be on top of it. Spirit is kind of saying something kind of falls into place. But for a few of you, this could be making some phone calls, going around visiting, talking about this vehicle, modifications or whatever. I feel like that you're going to get your way though, Virgo. The luck sector is completely clear, which is a good thing because it looks like that a lot of you have some things that have opened up. There's no claws, there's no distractions, there's no obstacles in your luck sector. So I would say if you're a gambling person, you might want to go ahead and play some slots, get you a couple of scratch offs this month because it looks like that there may be something that comes in for you. Let's see. Spell work good. We definitely have the High Priestess. Your intuition is really up. So for some of you, there's a lot of spiritual growth. The bullet casing is at the very edge, which is telling me that if there were obstacles with your spiritual development or anything like that, spirit has you. This is kind of blocking off any work that would be coming your way because it's closing off this section right here. Nothing can get in. And I feel like the bullet casing is your protection. So for some of you, this could be ancestors. This could be deities that you work with. High Priestess is showing that some of you come from a lineage. There's a connection with something or someone that is watching over you, which is good because in the bad work sector, spell work sector, we have definitely some issues with communication with someone. We have the dead turned upside down and we have the coffin nail. So some of you could be having an issue with somebody trying to use the dead or energy to work against you. We have a person way up here and it looks like they're looking at your money. So for a few of you, there may be some envy or jealousy over some type of money or opportunity that you have coming in. And I feel like with the coffin nail pointing towards your family, we have the cross, we have the thimble, and this is like protect your family, protect the people that you're with, protect your house. New job is on top of this, which means for some of you that there could be talks with a family member, or this could even be you, about a new job or money coming in. I feel like with the penis up here, this could be with a male, but of course it could be masculine energy, whether you're a male or a female. We do have protection with somebody could be worried about their home. Is it, you know, is my security system good enough? Do I have all I need to have? New job is on top of it. Some of you could be talking to a person about moving. We do have a new home that's coming in. We have some blockages with some spell work on top of this move. So you could have somebody or something that's trying to keep you stagnant. For a few of you, this could be dealing with a real estate agent or dealing with, you know, a loan officer. And it's like, okay, yeah, our communication is off. You know, things are not working out the way I want. They're not opening up or going in the direction I want. But it looks like that there's an opening right behind the shell where some of you are definitely going to get what you want. This new home is right on top of a key. Let me see if I can lift it up because it's kind of hard. It blends in. So for a few of you, if you're looking for a home, you may be receiving some really good news. But we got a claw here. We got a wolf's claw. So this could be. There's delays on top of this. The key is coming, but there's delays. There's some things that need to be worked out. Kyrie shell is turned upside down. So for some of you, it looks like the money. The money is not right. A few of you may have gotten into a home, but you're trying to get stable. You're trying to, you know, build your foundation. But it's like, okay, I got to worry about the money because maybe I put a big deposit down and my money is not there. So there's two things that are coming in, Virgo. For some of y'all, it's like, I want to move, but I don't have the money. And I see that that is going to be affecting you in a couple of different places. But I do feel like that this is not a no. This is just like a delay. Like you're going to have to work on your budget. The eye is upright on top of this, which means for a lot of y'all, y'all already know. Like I got to get my money right. This job is coming in. I need to go ahead and focus on this job so that I can get my money so I can turn these Kyra shells upside right. And with this key, get what I need. Now, moving into the love department, let's see, we got the screw on top of somebody who's face down. It's showing, though, that there could be some issues that need to be worked out when it comes to matters of the heart. Money is on top of the heart, which for some of y'all, be careful that you're not holding on to somebody, codependency, because I need you to survive. There also could be some problems with a relationship because of finances. Now, we have school on top of it. So what this is telling me is that for some of y'all, if you go to school, if there's education, more money is under this, which means that your education actually is opening more doors for you. So if you are worried about, you know, the money not being there, some of you could be going back to school. You could be getting certified in something. Some of you may already have this education sitting on top of this money, but it's showing that there's something that is opening up. I do see a screw on top of this person. Let me see if I can move this person out a little bit. So somebody could be a little bit burdened or feel a little bit burdened with money. Because it's like it's a work in progress. So I'm a workaholic. The screw is like I'm continuously going. There's no end to what I do. So some of you have to be really careful. And that could be, too, where this transformation is coming in, where maybe there was working yourself, you know, sick, depression and things like that. But we have somebody that is really working himself for the money. It's almost like I don't have enough. I don't have enough. And it could be, too, because you're trying to get this key. You're trying to make this move. Some of you could be looking at other ways to make money, another job that's coming in. But I'm definitely getting with the Kyra shells all turned upside down. The big factor for you guys this month is money. There is a disconnect with spirit. The Buddha is on the side. Let me pull him upright. And then we got the claws around him. So some of you may be too focused on the financial aspects of your life and not, you know, looking into other things. Could be there's a disconnect with spirit. We definitely have the Dead upside down over here where somebody could be using them to work against you. You are protected, though. So I don't want to say that you're absent. The ancestors have turned their back. They haven't. But they are showing some type of conflicts. And this could be, too, there may be some energy where there's something that is affecting your connection with spirit. I do get that within the next 4 months, there should be some major spiritual growth that comes through. Looks like there's some type of clarity that's going to come in for you guys. I do see that the main thing is the budget. It's almost like if my money is not right, nothing else is working for me. But you have some things that are opening up, and it's showing that you have everything that you need to make this money. The copper shells turned upside down to me is budget. It's budget. I need to manage my money a little bit better. I need to go ahead and utilize what I know, my skill set, to make money. I need to connect with spirit a little bit better to bring in money, because I definitely have some conflicts around with the way that I'm connecting. For some of you, this could even be a spiritual business, but you feel like it's not growing. You feel limited, but the money is there. Use your skill set. Use your education. For some of y'all, you're going to have to go back to school to get certified in something. This is the workaholic on top of you, you face down, and this on top of your back is literally somebody that's going and going and going and going, but that's kind of like a work harder, not smarter type of energy. So for a few of you, you might have to kind of reprogram this thinking over here. Now, I do feel like spirit is showing that you have the skill set. They're showing that there's some things that definitely are opening up for you. The house section is showing new home and a key. So I do feel like, and let me move it closer in, I do feel like that some of you are going to be getting some type of news about a move this year, if not this month, this year. And I feel like this may be a long time coming. So if you've been trying to save and you, I feel like you got to get a hold of your money. For some of y'all, I get a lot of emotion or emotional spending, or it's like, okay, I'm going to use this to build up my money. But there's something that's going off with the cycle. And then too, we got some work that's working against you over here. We definitely see that you need a little bit more protection with what you're doing. And this could be spiritual protection. For some of you, this could be dealing with people that you work with, or just having to watch your back with people that you work with. Your eye is up, but maybe there's something going on with communication. Some of y'all are missing something. Money over here is open, and we got you. I feel like this is you. Let's pull them up. So we have somebody that is striving. It's like, I don't want a little bit of money. I want big money. And I don't blame you, Virgo. I really don't. I feel like if you're going to do it, if you're going to go big. I feel like that whatever you're working towards, you are coming out on top. You just got to be careful that it doesn't cause problems within your family, that you don't work too hard or pull away from situations where you're neglecting the people around you. You have some things that maybe even if you have children that you're paying some money out, but I feel like that you got to get back on track. If you're trying to take care of other people, some of you are definitely going to have to get back on track because you are bringing in some money this year. But the thing about it is, with these thimbles and the cross in your family, I'm wondering if there could be some issue, too, where it's like, okay, I'm trying to protect what I have. I feel like spirit is watching over you. I feel like even though there's not a lot of messages up here, well, if you're a female, this could be, too, that you need to go ahead and, you know, do a well woman checkup. Some of you could be hearing about a pregnancy. This could be hormonal issues. This could be going through menopause. But I feel for the most part, spirit is really on top of your health. And it seems to be more what they're focused on than the money situation. They already know that you have the skill set or whatever you need to open up for money. Even though there's some obstacles, they know that you can make money. Your money sector is free and clear. You're laying in it. Some of you, this is going to be a power couple. You're going to connect with somebody that is either a money person like you, or if you're already in a relationship, it looks like both y'all are focused on money. But we got a person over here. One is standing straight up. The other one is bent down. So I'm wondering, too, if this is Somebody may have a disability or they may be limited with what they can do to make money. This could be also, some of you may be a caretaker or feel like a caretaker of a person because they're not straight. Everybody else is straight. This is my first time realizing that he's been. But it kind of brought to my attention on top of the money, that's limitations. Some of you may be feeling limited by this person. Or this person may be feeling limited that they can only do so much financially. But I still feel like it's a power couple though. So this might be a mindset. If you have a roommate, family member, somebody you're going into business with them and they're like, you know, I can only work 3 days a week. You know, I get headaches. I have other issues. And you're like, cool, don't worry about it. I'm a workaholic. I'm going to pick up the slack. We're going to do this. You know, we're trying to get a home. We're trying to get some stability going in. We got some opposition. We got some spirits that may be working against us or some people that are working against us. We kind of see this. We're focused on the money. You know, you take care of you. Let me do what I do. But I feel like that some of you are very protective of your space, your material things, your family, your loved ones. Makes sense, though, because with the bullet casing, you're being protected. High Priestess is on top of you. So if there's any type of issue, you're already on it because you see it. So I feel like some of you are going to be feeling like I need to step up more. Here's the thing though, with the screw, you're already overworking yourself and you need to be careful with your health. Even though there is a transformation, I don't want you to wear yourself out, Virgo, where you come back and it's like, okay, I'm sick again. Things are falling apart for me. We don't want that. I love this, you know, work in progress and let's keep going because that's the energy that I have. But I have to tell you, you know, I almost got sat down this month because I felt like, damn, you know, I'm getting a sinus infection. I'm having headaches, you know, my body is hurting. And spirit was like, slow your ass down. So I had to take 3 days off this week because it's like, I can't continue to do this. So for some of you, you're going to have to watch yourself with that. Just because the dead is right here. I do feel like because they're looking in either direction, I feel like that they're trying to watch over you, but it's almost kind of like work smarter, not harder. Some of you, I definitely feel like you're doing this because of your family. There could, too, be a fear of poverty. Just because the car shows are all turned down. You have more money. You have the ability to make money. But it's like, okay, I don't see it. I don't see it. I don't have enough. So for some of you, you could be doing really, really well. But you feel like, I don't see it. I have to keep working. I have to keep pushing. So there could be a perception there. And two, it could be that whatever you're working for, this home or this big thing that you're trying to get, if this is a business or a home, there's a key that you want. Maybe you need to come up with more money and you feel like the only way to get it is I got to work harder. But spirit is saying, listen. And it could be too, why the Buddha is surrounded by these claws, because there's like a disconnect there. Some of you got to get out of the way and let spirit come in and do what they need to do. Which means that you may need to step back. And for some of you, it may be hard for you to do because it's like you're used to being in control. Let me see. Let's pull some cards, Virgo. You have the Amethyst and the Loa or the deity. So if you are working with the Loa, Orisha, or any deity, there is a connection there. Dead is looking right at this. So it shows that there definitely is a connection, but there could be something with feeling limited or feeling like spirit really isn't coming through the way you need, but they're kind of blocked off. It looks like some obstacles on top of it. Something needs to be opened up. And for some of you, this could be spending more time with them. Because the devil is in good spell work, which means that if this is not a person that's trying to work against you to your detriment, but some of you, you could be your own worst enemy because the devil is in your good spell workhouse. We have protection here, but we have an energy there. High Priestess, though, it's like, I know this. You got to tell me this, Diva. I already know it. I don't need to hear this from you. I know I'm a workaholic. I know I self-sabotage. I know my family is important. Well, God damn it, Virgo. Act like it. Act like it and restructure. Restructure the shit. A lot of you are gifted. But you got to make sure that you're not sabotaging yourself or working yourself to the bone. Virgo, 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 Virgo spirit for March. Virgo, what do we have, Virgo? All right, let's see what we have. We have Four of Cups, antisocial, stuck, boredom. Maybe of the same routine. Maybe because we got this thing of working for money, 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 focused on money. So for some of you, you know, everything is a routine. I wake up, I do the same shit every day. I go to work, I do the same shit every day. On the weekends, I do this. It's the same shit every day. Also, one-sided relationship, too. Some of you may be even feeling like you're carrying a load. And then we have the Four of Swords, caution, obstacles, slow movement. Four of Swords could be sickness, needing to take a break, needing to rest. Some of you need a vacation. And I know the first thing that you're going to say is, I don't have the money. I'm working. I got my hours. I can't take off work. But your education, your knowledge is bringing money in. So you need to restructure that because it looks like you could be making more money. So for some of you, it's like, okay, yeah, I might need to put $5 aside every week. Give up on my Starbucks or whatever my little breakfast thing is or whatever and put that in, you know, take a drive somewhere, get a nice hotel. May not be able to go to the islands this year, but for some of you, definitely, you need to kind of step out. And then we got a Knight of Cups, a sensitive, romantic, caring person. This probably is in your love house. Let's see. And we got imbalance, conflicts, lack of long-term vision. Some of you are worried about a water sign person, and it could be this person over here that's kind of bent. Some of you are worried about that person, like where exactly are they going? What exactly are they doing? There could be some mood swings. There could be some emotions there that are going on with this person and you're worried about it. But it looks like that your protection is on this person. Like, I don't want anything to happen to them. So some of you may be very protective. This could be a child. You know, this could be somebody that you are caretaking. This could be somebody that you're trying, you know, to carry. Or you feel like you are carrying. Some of you, I think you're using this person as an excuse to work the way you do. But I feel like there's a fear of poverty. Some of you, if this is a person that you've been with for a while, it could be that we've gone through some stuff. I don't want to lose this stuff that we built up. We need a new home. We need this. But maybe you are not on the same, you and this person are not on the same page about how you're going to get there. We definitely have some imbalance that's coming in on that water sign. Now, we do have the Four of Pentacles, and it's showing holding on to money, worried about the budget, a lack of flow. So that kind of goes back to the cowra shells all turned upside down. I don't have enough money, but we got a new job coming in. We got education going back to school or either using your skill set to bring in this more money. This big ass chip that's turned upwards, which means that you're actually sitting on money. Two of Pentacles, juggling money, Virgo. King of Wands, leadership, business, risk takers. But then we have martyrdom. I got to sacrifice myself for everybody else around me. You don't have to, Virgo. And then we have High Priestess over here again, too. You don't have to sacrifice. I think what you're doing is, say I'm thinking for you. But there's an energy of I got to protect my family. So some of you may be the older child or the person that had to be responsible in a lot of your relationships, or either you're dealing with somebody that is like that for you. It's like, I got to take care of you. I got to make sure that things are okay. There definitely, I feel like, is some type of, for some of you, codependency of, I don't want to be alone and do this alone. But it could go back to that fear of lack. The High Priestess is showing that you have powers, that you have intuition, that you have spirit connection, but you may not be using them to the best of your ability. But I think spirit is showing you everything that you need to. And then we got stagnation, blocked energy over here where the Buddha is closed in. Burdened by work. Let's pull one more card. Unmotivated. We got unmotivated three times. Sickly, dealing with some type of health issue. Melancholy. I'm not motivated. I don't feel good. I'm tired. I'm exhausted. Some of you definitely need a trip. You do need a trip. The environment that you're in is not conducive for you anymore. It's not making you happy. It's not good for your energy. But then we got the dead turned upside down. Some of you definitely need to do a cleanse in your space. Clear out that energy. I think because we only have one person in the money sector, that there could be somebody that feels like I'm the only one that's bringing in money. And then we got the family over here, protection, the cross, burdened, feeling like I have to do some things. Spirit is talking to you, though. High Priestess, Amethyst on top of you. And then we have the ancestors over here, and they're like, open up, let us in. So I will say spiritual cleanse, spiritual bath. I feel like for some of you, you definitely need to, because you're face down and you're working way too hard. You're pushing and pushing and pushing, but where are you trying to go? Because it's almost like obligation. I'm doing this because I feel obligated, not because I'm passionate about it or I'm happy about it. There's a difference between working and doing something that you love versus working and doing something that you just have to do to pay the bills. I'm blessed to do something that I love, and it changes that energy because I wake up in the morning and I'm like, I want to work. I want to do it. I want to work. Come on. Let's have some fun. Let's do this. Versus when I used to have to go into this building and wear a uniform, and you know, they told me when to clock in, when to clock out, and I was like, oh, fuck y'all, I don't want to do this. The quality of my energy and my work wasn't the same because I wasn't working for me. So some of you, I feel like that you may have to switch some things off. Entrepreneurship may even become an end. Whatever it is, you don't seem to be really, I don't feel like that you're passionate about something that you're doing. And for some, the last card I pulled is the Empress, fertility. If you're a woman, definitely could be that some of this sluggishness and stuff is from pregnancy. But if you're a male or a woman who's not trying to have a baby, some of this is literally trying to open a business, give birth to something, and it's moving slow and it's taking a lot of your energy. And you're feeling drained because you're worried about money. Am I going to have enough to take care of my family? Because I don't want to let somebody down. So there's definitely an energy that's coming in, Virgo. Here's the thing. Spirit is on top of it, and they're telling me you're going through a transformation with your energy. You also have more money coming in from your skill set and your education. Maybe you don't need to be working for somebody. Maybe it's time for you to start a business and use your skills for you. Open it up. Maybe you're too smart for where you're at. And it's draining you. It's like, you know, putting somebody that is high honored into a class that doesn't challenge them. And then it's like, okay, why is this kid, you know, doodling all day and, you know, wasting their energy or their time? It's because they're not challenged. They're not getting any excitement from what they're doing. So some of you, I feel like, Virgo, are going to be looking into entrepreneurship or a new job. There's a move that's coming in too. So it could even be, I need a new environment. I don't want to be here anymore. But I definitely will say you need a vacation. You need to get one of those little saving apps. And even if you put in $2, it's still showing you that you're doing something towards taking care of yourself, towards going somewhere. All right, Virgo? So let me know in the comments how you feel about this reading. I know it kind of got a little deep, and I'm Venus Virgo, so I was like, I get it. I'm a workaholic, but I do have the skill set to make more money so that I don't have to work as hard as I do. I don't have to do these videos every month. I love doing them. But Spirit is maybe telling me, you know, come on, you ain't got to do this shit every month. Take a break. You know, maybe you need a vacation. Maybe you need to switch it up, do something different. So I get the message, Virgo. Let me know how it resonates with you. All right, my loves. Be safe. Love you.